الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هلك عليه الصلاة والسلام وأتم التسليم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم اجعلنا منهم ومن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر آمين يا رب العالمين قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أن أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله اصطفى آدم ونوحا وآل إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم وآل عمران على العالمين ذرية بعضها من بعض والله سميع عليم إذ قالت امرأة عمران رب إني نذرت لك ما في بطني محررا فتقبل مني إنك أنت السميع العليم فلما وضعتها قالت رب إني وضعتها أنثى والله أعلم بما وضعت وليس الذكر كالأنثى وإني سميتها مريم وإني أعيذها بك وذريتها من الشيطان الرجيم فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا وكفلها زكريا كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب هنالك دعا زكريا ربه قال رب هب لي من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء فنادته الملائكة وهو قائم يصلي في المحراب أن الله يبشرك بيحيى مصدقا بكلمة من الله وسيدا وحصورا ونبيا من الصالحين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي نستغفر الله ربنا من كل ذنب ونتوب إليك ربنا زدنا علما آمين يا رب العالمين Alhamdulillah, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by seeking His help, by thanking Him for this opportunity, and that we seek forgiveness for all our mistakes and shortcomings, that we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all our sins. Before I continue with my khutbah today, I just want to remind everyone that Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ That when the call is made for Juma, the adhan is made for Juma, it's time for Juma, Allah says, فَسْعَوْ Rush, hurry, quicken to hasten to the salah, وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ And leave all transactions. This is leaving our work, whatever businesses we have. So as the Imam has already, sorry, the Muaddin already gave the adhan, I saw some people like, you know, using the machine, please avoid that, inshallah. Just, you can do it after. So in the salah, adhan is called, refrain from everything. And inshallah, focus completely in salah. Okay, just a reminder for myself and everybody here. Alhamdulillah. So inshallah, I recited a few ayat from Surah Ali Imran, talking about the family of Ali Imran, and most importantly, Maryam alayhi salam. So inshallah, today's khutbah will be focused on the best of women, Maryam alayhi salam. You know, they say that behind every great man is a great woman. And that is actually true. You will see that obviously a man cannot come without a woman. So that's in that sense, every man, behind every man is a great woman. But even you see throughout history, for every prophet or every leader in Islam had someone, some woman was, you know, supporting him. So we see that Musa alayhi salam cannot be Musa alayhi salam without his mother, without his wife, without his sister, and his stepmother Asiya rahimahullah. Right? All of these women play a big role in the life of Musa alayhi salam to make his personality and to form Musa alayhi salam. And then we have Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa cannot be without Khadija radiallahu anha. And then we see that Umar radiallahu an, he would not have become Umar radiallahu an if it was not for his sister who helped him convert to Islam. And then we see that Abdullah bin Zubair could not have been Abdullah bin Zubair without his mother motivating him to fight against the enemies. And Bukhari, Imam Bukhari rahimahullah, is not possible for Imam Bukhari to become Imam Bukhari without his mother. And we see Imam Malik cannot be possible without his mother. And Imam Shafi'i, not possible without his mother. And most importantly, Isa alayhi salam. Isa alayhi salam is Isa alayhi salam because of the righteousness of his mother. So inshallah, in today's khutbah, I want to focus on the mother of Isa alayhi salam, Maryam salamun alayha. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, there are four women who are the best. The best four women in the Quran. Who are they? Some of them are not mentioned in the Quran, but they're four best women. Number one is Maryam alayhi salam, Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun, and then we have Khadija radiallahu anha and Fatima radiallahu anha. So inshallah, let's talk about Maryam alayhi salam. Maryam alayhi salam was from the family of Ali Imran. Allah says in Surah Al Imran, Surah Al Imran is named after this family. Al means family, Imran is Imran. So the family of Imran, Allah says, Inna Allah astafa. Allah chose Adam, Nuh, Al Ibrahim, the family of Ibrahim, and Ali Imran, and the family of Imran over all people. So what was so special that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this family? Learning their life and learning their inner dimensions will help us rectify our families and also make our families among the best, inshaAllah. ذُرِّيَّةً بَعْضُهَا مِنْ بَعْضُ وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ إِذْ قَالَتْ امْرَأَةُ عِمْرَانَ رَبِّي. When the wife of Imran made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi, inni nadartu laka ma fi batani muharraran fataqabbal minni. So before I move on, so we have these two people, Ali Imran, so Imran, and then his wife was Hanna. So Imran and Hanna did not have a child for a very, very long time. And finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses Imran and Hanna with a child. So Hanna, rahimahullah, she becomes pregnant. And while she is pregnant, she makes this dua. And every mother should make this dua. Ya Rabbi, inni nadartu laka ma fi batani muharraran fataqabbal minni. I have devoted whatever is in my stomach to you. Whatever is in my womb, I have devoted this child for your sake, for your service of the service of your deen, ya Allah. Accept this from me. Fataqabbal minni, innaka antas samiul alim. Indeed, you're always hearing and always knowing. So she makes this dua that, Ya Allah, basically I want to make this child in the masjid. Dedicate this child in the masjid and for your service. And so what happens, she gives birth. And what happens is that she gives birth to a female. So it's Maryam alayhi salam. And then she's shocked. Ya Allah, I have given birth to a female. I was expecting a male because in those days, only male can go in the masjid and spend their time and become, scholars. Those days, women were not allowed to go to the masjid. And so she could not go. She was shocked. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says something beautiful. وَلَيْسَ ذَكْرُكَ الْأُنْثَى. A female is not like a male. I know what you don't know. I have some plan. Accept whatever the qadr is. And a lot of people, they expect a male, for example. And, they expect, then female comes out. And then they're completely, shocked and they are unhappy with Allah's decision. So Allah says, I know what you don't know, trust me. And before she gives birth, she makes a dua. In her dua, she says, I want to make this child muharrar. Muharrar means sacred, free, right? Free from this world. I want to make this child your slave, ya Allah. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua of this mother. And likewise, Maryam alayhi salam turned out to be, righteous child. And we see that, the women were not allowed to go to the masjid, but because of the dua of the mother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made arrangements for Maryam alayhi salam to spend her time in masjid. So we have Zakariya alayhi salam, her uncle. He comes forward and he says, you know, I will take care of this child. And Zakariya alayhi salam was a high official in the university. This is Masjid al-Aqsa basically. So in Masjid al-Aqsa, he had a high position. And so he says, I will take care of this child. And he makes a mihrab for Maryam alayhi salam. Mihrab is a place, a room where you can pray, and a dedicated place for Maryam alayhi salam. And so Maryam alayhi salam grows up in the masjid. Look at that, it's completely against the norm for a female to be in the masjid, in the university, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts her dua and makes her among the people of Masjid al-Aqsa. And so she grows up, you know, أَنْبَتَهَا نَبَاتًا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nurtured her, protected her from every single thing. To the point that her worship was so much, she used to fast, she used to, you know, feed the poor. And she was known in the entire university as a mother of giver, right? A mother who feeds the poor. The mother who, you know, supports. Mother isn't it just not actual mother. So then what happens, she grows and her iman was so high and she was so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that one day what happens is Zakariya alayhi salam enters the room of Maryam alayhi salam and he sees that Maryam alayhi salam has these fruits in front of her. In winter months, she would have fruits from summer. And in summer months, she would have fruits from winter. And it's not possible to, you know, have those fruits. You know, those fruits do not grow in that area. And so he questions, Zakariya alayhi salam questions Maryam alayhi salam, أَنَّا لَكِ هَذَا How is this possible? Where is this coming from? There, Maryam alayhi salam is teaching a lesson to her own uncle. إِنَّ اللَّهَ O my uncle, ya Zakariya, right? O my uncle. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ Allah gives to whomever He wants, whatever He wants, without any hisab. You make dua to Allah. She is teaching him the lesson of dua. And this is going back to our previous topic on dua. We'll see a lot of duas in this, the power of dua. First one was the acceptance of Hannah radiallahu anha, rahimahullah's dua. That this child did become muharrar, free from all evil. And then she teaches Zakariya alayhi salam to make dua Allah can give. Now Zakariya alayhi salam is very old. He's the uncle. And he did not have a child either for a very long time. And so right then and there, he raises his hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هُنَالِكَ دَعَى زَكَرِيَّ رَبَّهُ He calls out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? And what is the dua? In Surah Maryam, Allah says, إِذْ نَادَ رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيَ قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ الشَّقِيَّ Oh my master, my bones have become weak. Meaning I'm old person now. And my hair has turned grey to show how old he is. And وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ الشَّقِيَّ وَإِنِّي الْخِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي وَكَانَتْ إِمْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيًّا Says, my wife is also barren. So biologically it's not possible for us to produce a child. Ya Allah, but I know you have never rejected my dua. I'm making this sincere dua to you, Ya Allah. For you there is no limitation. When you say kun, it becomes fayakun. I fear that after I die, my people will not take care of me. Well, you know, will not take care of the religion, will misuse this religion. Because these are Bani Israel, and we study in the Quran, Bani Israel, how they changed the Quran, the scriptures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was scared that the divine revelation will be altered. So he makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happens, as he's making dua in the mihrab, the angels descend. And they say, O Zakariya, Allah has accepted your dua. We will grant you Yahya. We'll grant you Yahya, a son named Yahya. And no one was given this name Yahya before. And Yahya means to give life. So he's going to give life to your legacy that you think was going to come to an end. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses Yahya alayhi salam to Zakariya alayhi salam. And so that's how Maryam alayhi salam grows, you know, as a child. And then what happens then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ O Maryam, because of your righteousness, because of your modesty, we'll talk about modesty in a second, because of your righteousness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you. There are three words used in the Quran for choosing someone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is this ikhtara, istafa, and ijtaba, right? First, ikhtara is used for Musa alayhi salam, to choose someone. Why? Ikhtara comes from khayr, goodness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose a person to be his prophet, to be his propagator, to be the propagator of deen, if there is khayr inside you. So Allah chose Musa alayhi salam because he had khair inside him. Yes, he made a lot of mistakes, but he had, there was khair inside him, so Allah chose him. Here, the word used for Maryam alayhi salam is istafa, the second word used for choosing. Istafa is to choose someone because of their purity. This person is clean, modest, protected their shame, they protected their eyes, they were guarding themselves. That's what Allah subhanahu chose. So in Allah istafaki wa tahharaki, Allah chose you Maryam alayhi salam and he purified you, wa tahharaki wa istafaki ala nisa'il alameen, and he chose you over all the women of this dunya, right? That's a title Maryam alayhi salam gets. Now with every blessing there is a test. Her strength was modesty, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test her with that very thing. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what happens, she grows up and she is secluded somewhere. Then what happens, a human being appears, a man appears in front of her, right? When she was completely alone. And she says, Inni a'udhu bir-Rahman. Allah is testing her to see what her reaction is. Her reaction was, A'udhu bir-Rahman. I seek protection from the Most Merciful. Don't come close to me. And then right away when she reads this, and what happened, the human being turns into the angelic form, which was Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam came, when he would come in the human form, he would come in the best forms. So he comes and he turns into angelic form. He says, O Maryam, indeed I am an angel from Allah, I am a Rasul from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am here to give you the glad tidings of Isa alayhi salam, that you are going to become a mother. And she's completely shocked. How is it possible? How can I become pregnant when no man has touched me? Right? وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. And so Allah says, Jibreel says to Maryam alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wants something, he does kun fayakun, this is it, you will become. And you know, something beautiful, why did she say Ar-Rahman? I seek refuge from the Most Merciful, don't come close to me. What she's telling this human being, initially it was a human being, is that you are trying to do something wrong, but know that Allah is Ar-Rahman. Allah is most loving. You can still turn to Allah. Don't do this. Don't come close to me. Right? She's teaching a lesson to this human being that shows her righteousness, what level of iman she had. And where are the women of today? Where are the Maryam alayhi salam of today? And you know, it's sad that females, and the Prophet also predicted this, that the first people to be following, most people to follow the Dajjal will be the females. And we don't have women role models today. Alhamdulillah, men have some form of training, some form of Juma is there and all that, but our females, our sisters need a lot of help. So us community need to focus on our sisters. And so Maryam alayhi salam, she what does she say as soon as she gets a good news that she's going to become pregnant? She says, I wish I was dead. Mittu qabla hadha. I wish I was dead before this. You know why? Because of the accusations she has to go through now. People will torture her. People will slander her. People will, raise fingers on her shame and say and question her modesty. And so people will torture her, and the crime, the same as, as Islam, the crime for adultery, people will start saying that you are fornicated, you have committed adultery, and the punishment for that is going to be stoning to death. And she will be stoned to death. And she has to see the child stoning to death. And she has to go through labor pains. All these things she was thinking, she's like, I wish I was dead before this. مَتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًّا فَنَادَهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا. Allah calls her to Maryam alayhi salam. O Maryam alayhi salam, أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي. Do not be sad, do not grieve. You know, all of us will go through this in our life. Where you will say, I wish I was dead. It's a natural thing. Yes, you should never wish for death. It's a natural thing that can happen. We're so overwhelmed with something. And the thing that you are strong with, Allah will test you with that. That's a powerful lesson here. If you think your strength is wealth, that you have a lot of wealth, Allah will test you with wealth. If you think your strength is teaching, Allah will test you with teaching. If you think your strength is helping others, Allah will test you with that. If you think your strength is obeying your parents, Allah will test you with that. If you think your strength is being nice to your wife, Allah will test you with that. Whatever it is, your strength, Allah will use that and test you to see how strong actually you are in this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests Maryam alayhi salam through her modesty. And so she says, Allah says to her, أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي قَدْ جَعَلْ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيَّا. Lay down here, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make a river flow under you. Allah will make water flow under you. وهزي إليك بجذع النخلة تساقط عليك رطبا جنيا. And she lies down under the date palm. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Maryam salam, O Maryam alayhi salam, shake the branch. حُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِزْعِ النَّخْلَةِ. Shake the date palm's branch of the date palm, and dates will fall. And now here's the question. When you want the dates to fall, what do you shake? You shake the trunk or the branches? You shake the branches, right? You cannot shake the trunk. You cannot move the trunk. And she's pregnant, she's weak, she's a woman. And so Allah is saying, why is he saying, if Allah is going to drop the dates anywhere to her, so she can eat the dates, why is he telling her to, like, you know, push and shake the branches? The lesson here is tawakkul. That if you want to do tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to do whatever you can. Even if that means shaking the branch. Allah wants you to do your effort. You cannot just make dua to Allah and let things happen from the sky. Things will not fall from the sky. Whatever you can do, you know, move your hand, do something. And then you can expect Allah's help to come. It's the same thing with Musa alayhi salam, when he has to split the sea, he strikes the staff and then the sea splits. The sea did not split because of the staff. It's Allah who split the sea. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Musa alayhi salam to do something, do some action, work. And then you can help, you expect for my help. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Maryam alayhi salam, move the date palm and dates will fall. A side point here for the pregnant woman is good to give them dates. There's a lot of science behind it as well. And then what happens, now here Jibreel alayhi salam says something beautiful. Oh Maryam, when you were born, your mother was like female, Ya Allah. She was sad to give birth to you because you're a female. And you are sad about yourself and you're saying, I wish I was dead. But you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a bigger plan for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to make you the best of women. He wanted to make you the best of women. And here is, you know, never be satisfied with Allah's decision and never question what happens to you. And so then she goes to the people and she's sad, Allah, and she carries the baby with her and she's going to the people. And then Allah tells her, what should you say? When the people ask you, where is this baby from? I've never seen you, where is your husband, all that? Quli, say that I'm fasting. That I am fasting, sawman. Inni nazartu lirrahmani sawman. I'm fasting, do not speak. Here's the other lesson. When people slander you and say bad things about you, about your organization, about your family, about your things, the best thing to do is complete silence. Sawman, quiet. Fasting in those days was to be quiet, not stopping from eating. And then people started blaming her. Oh, ya ukhta Harun, oh sister of Harun, how could you do this? Your father wasn't like this, your brother wasn't like this, how could you do this? And then she's completely silent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests her. And then what happens then after her test? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes Isa alayhi salam speak. Inni Abdullah. The baby speaks, and she was carrying the baby. Isa alayhi salam speaks from birth. That's another miracle of Isa alayhi salam. And he memorized Tawran Injil from birth. It says, Inni Abdullah atani al-kitab. I am the servant of Allah. I'm not God. Keep that in mind, okay? I was born as a miracle. But I'm not God. Abdullah. I'm the servant of Allah. أتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. He gave me the book and he made me a prophet. وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا وبرا بوالديه ولم أكن جبارا شقيا والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا. That I am going to be righteous to my parent and that peace be upon me the day I was born, the day I will die, and the day I will be resurrected. And that's Isa speaks and defends the righteous mother, Maryam alayhi salam. قُلُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِلِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. Some lessons we can derive from the story of Maryam alayhi salam. Maryam alayhi salam is taught a lot in the Quran. Isa alayhi salam is taught a lot in the Quran. So it's our, you know, there's a lot to learn from it. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it. So the first thing we can learn is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The worship of Allah, it's your sujood, it's your good deeds that will protect you from dangers, that will protect you from difficult situations. You remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in times of ease, Allah will remember you in times of difficulties. That is the lesson here. That Maryam alayhi salam, as a young child, she worshipped She did all her ibadat. That's what Allah loves, the worship of a young person. When you're old, when you don't have desires, then you did, yeah, it's not a big deal. But a youth who grows up in the worship of Allah, he will be among the seven kinds of people who will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lesson number two, guard your shame. And if you want Allah to raise your level, you need to prove that you're worthy of it. And you see that Maryam alayhi salam, when she guarded her shame, she was chosen as the best woman. When Yusuf alayhi salam, when he protected himself from that woman, what happens? Yusuf alayhi salam became the finance minister, become the king of Egypt. So when you show to Allah that you're worthy of it, Allah will raise you in status. Lesson number three, you'll be tested with your strengths. You will be tested with your strength. Allah will test you. And this is only a test to see how strong you are. And number four, silence speaks when words fail. Silence speaks when words fail. Sometimes the best answer to give is silence. Sometimes you can't speak. A person comes to Prophet ﷺ and says, in front of all the people, says, so are you saying that you are better than Abdul Muttalib? Are you saying that you are better than the grandfather who worshipped idols? And so if the Prophet ﷺ says yes, it's going to be a big mess because you all respected Abdul Muttalib. Like, how dare you say that, right? If he says no, then that's not right. So the Prophet does not answer. In that situation, the best answer is does not, no answer. Right? It's just the situation is, right? Sometimes silence is better than any words. And lesson number five, if you have taqwa, then Allah will show you miracles. When you have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even a baby can speak for you to defend you. Right? That's what we see again and again and again, the power of dua and how Allah's help comes, in times of difficulties. And the power of dua, Hanna radiallahu anha makes dua, how her dua comes true. You know, she says, I want to keep this baby free from all evils, and there are only two children who are not pricked by shaitan. When every baby is born, it's pricked by shaitan, and there are two babies who never cried when they were born. First, one of them is Isa alayhi salam, the other one is Maryam alayhi salam. Right? These two babies did not cry at birth because of the dua of the grandmother. Now we see the last lesson is that we don't know Allah's plan. Be satisfied with whatever you go through in life. قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ مَا شَافَعَ. That's the final lesson, that whatever ups and downs you go through in our life, Allah has a plan for us. That Maryam alayhi salam had to go through all those difficulties because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to make her the best woman. And you don't know whatever, level is in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the final hadith that we'll conclude with, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for some people, He loves them so much, He loves some people so much, that He wants them to be in a high level in Jannah. Very high level in Jannah. Not just in Jannah, but high level in Jannah. But their deeds are not enough to get them to that level. They don't have that many good deeds to get there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts them in difficulties. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them, puts them in difficult situations. Through those difficulties, they make more and more dua, they are patient, and their darajat are increasing and increasing and increasing. Right? SubhanAllah. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us sabr in times of difficulties. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gives birth to women like Maryam alayhi salam, gives birth to mothers like Maryam alayhi salam and Hanna rahimahullah, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keeps us steadfast on our deen. Ibadallah, yarhamukumullah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkari wal baghi ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun wa dhkurullaha al-'azima yadhkurukum wa shkuru 'ala ni'mihi yazidukum wa la dhikrullahi akbar. Allahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un.